Hello children, today we are going to learn essay writing. The word essay is defined in the concise Oxford Dictionary as a literary composition, usually prose and short, on any of the subject. It is a written composition giving expression to one's own personal ideas or opinions on some topic, in which we give our personal ideas or opinions on some topic. But the term usually covers also any written composition, whether it expresses personal opinions or gives information on any given subject or details of a narrative or description. Characteristics of essay writing. A good essay must contain the following characteristics like unity, order, brevity, style, personal touch. An essay must be a unity, treating in an orderly manner of one subject. It should be concisely written, it should be briefly written, and it should be to the point, and it should be not too long and not too short. And the style should be very simple, direct and clear. It should not confuse anyone. And it should have an individuality or show the personal touch of the writer. Essays may be classified as narrative, descriptive, expository, reflective, imaginative. Narrative. In a narrative essay, the writer tells a story about a real life experience. He talks about real life experience. While telling a story may sound easy to do, the narrative essay challenges students to think and write about themselves. When writing a narrative essay, writers should try to involve the reader by making the story as vivid as possible. The writer should make his story very interesting so that reader should take interest. Descriptive. A descriptive essay paints a picture with words. A writer might describe a person, place, object, or even memory of special significance which has special importance. The descriptive essay strives to communicate a deeper meaning through the description. The descriptive essay is mainly based on the description. In a descriptive essay, the writer should show through the use of colorful words and sensory details, as the colorful words will attract the readers. Expository. In an expository essay, the writer explains or defines a topic using facts, statistics and examples which he collects from his sources. Expository writing encompasses a wide range of essay variations, such as the comparison and contrast essay. It is making comparison and contrast. The cause and effect essay. It also shows the causes and effect and how to or process essay. Reflective. A reflective essay consists of reflections or thoughts on some topic, which is generally of an abstract nature. For example, writer is explaining his habits, qualities, social, political and domestic topics, philosophical subject, religious and theological topics, and also he gives his personal views about the topic. Imaginative. Essays on subjects such as the feelings and experiences of the sailor wrecked on a desert island may be called imaginative. Essays in such, the writer is called to place himself in imagination in a position of which he has had no actual experience. Such subjects as "If I were a king," "If I were a principal," "The autobiography of a horse" would call for imaginative essays, where the child has to use his imagination. How to write an effective essay. Every essay has a beginning, a middle, and an end. In a 5-paragraph essay, the first paragraph is called the introduction. In first paragraph, we need to give an introduction related to that topic. The next 3 paragraphs consist of the body of the essay. And 5th and final paragraph is the conclusion. In the body, we can take any stats or any data related to that subject and our views about that. And in conclusion, we are writing how we can express our views, how it is related to real life, and so on. Overview of essay writing. Overview of an essay. First, we have introduction, general statements, and information about the topic, in which we are giving our general statements and we are giving information about the topic thoroughly. Thesis statement lists the main ideas in the essay. What are the main ideas that is included in the thesis? Then there are three body paragraphs which support the main ideas of the essay. Begins with topic sentences. Now the essay ends with conclusion, in which we include brief summary of main points of the essay. A very basic thesis statement is one or two sentences at the end of the first paragraph that tells the reader the main idea of your essay. So you should include such sentences in your essay which gives the reader the main idea of your essay. A thesis statement should do these three things. It should clearly express what the essay is about. You should keep the points clear to express your essay. You should make a discussable point. It should indicate the structure of the essay. The structure of the essay must be clear. In first paragraph, we are giving introduction. Then we are giving thesis statement, which includes 2-3 paragraphs. Then we'll move on to the conclusion. Conclusion, the end. This part contains the conclusions and findings. Whatever we think proves that the theme announced at the beginning of the essay is fully disclosed. We should have to keep in our mind that our points are fully disclosed. Necessarily express your personal opinion about the work done. The concluding paragraph typically has two parts: the summary statement in one or two sentences, which restate the thesis in a fresh way to reinforce the essay's main idea, which is depicting the main idea of the essay, what we think about that. The clincher is a final thought which should create a lasting impression on the reader. It also referred to as the closer, is your last opportunity to connect with the reader. It means you are telling your final judgment or what you are thinking about the topic. I hope it is clear. Thank you.